Alright, let's continue a bit of this. I think we're like 2/3 of the way, something along those lines. Yeah, apologies if there's like some discrepancy between how I don't know what voice I gave this dude. So, okay, what are we doing? You wouldn't happen to speak English as well, would you? Okay, it's no use. She doesn't understand a word I say. Hey there, officer. Oh, Tanamura-san, you couldn't have come at a better time. Is something wrong? No, but it sounds like this woman is looking for someone, but she can't speak Japanese, so I'm not really sure what to do. I was trying to get her to follow me back to the station so we could have an interpreter help us, but she doesn't seem to be keen on leaving the spot. I see, I'll take things from here. Thanks, and sorry about this. Can I leave her to you then? No worries. If you had taken her to the station, I would have been the interpreter anyways. So it saves time if I just do it here instead. Hey, you got a point there. Thanks again. Well then. I am a police officer. You can talk to me about whatever it is you're having trouble with. Great. I finally found someone I can converse with. My name is Tanamura. I'm with the Tokyo Metro Police Department. Who are you? I'm Nair. Nair? Nair? I don't know. That's a brand in Australia for hair removal. It's like what is it? I think they use it for legs mainly, but it's no hair. Nair. Anyway. Nair, nice to meet you. I'm guessing you're from Southeast Asia. Anyways, you're looking for someone, right? That's right. Well, actually, I'm a detective too.
You? A detective?
That's right. I followed a criminal to Japan to bring him to justice.
Can you just do that?
Do the Japanese police know what you're up to here? I contacted the Japanese police before I left. They're supposed to be helping. But once I got here, everyone seemed so busy. No one would help me with my investigation. Oh, I see. Everything's a bit of a mess right now, so I bet not everyone knows you're even here. I was also told I would be given an interpreter. And I'm guessing you didn't get that either. I apologize for the inconvenience. It's not your fault. I'm just happy to finally talk to someone I can understand. Glad to be of assistance. But I have a little dilemma. We have permission to investigate, but we don't have the authority to make arrests. In Japan, only the Japanese police are allowed to make arrests. You've got a point there, but it's not our investigation. We can't make an arrest without sufficient evidence. There is evidence. That's why my colleagues and I came to Japan, hoping for some help from you guys.
Colleagues?
They're out at the embassy now. Tanamura-san, would you come with me for a bit? You still think it's $20? You've been craving some kind of survival shenanigans lately. Yeah. I've been wanting to do some Terraria as well, but I'm waiting for the new patch to drop, but apparently it's end of this month coming up in September, so I don't know. We'll see. And since that Calamity mod thing is done, I was kind of thinking of doing that. But yeah, I would wait until, like, Raft is on sale. I don't know. I don't want to spend too much on it. What is this place? We don't have cell phones that work in Japan right now, so this is our rendezvous point. I see now. That's why you couldn't follow that officer to the police station. The criminal we're seeking won't be in Japan for long, so we have to investigate quickly, along with the embassy and Chinese police. Tanamura-san, would you please help us? We have to catch our criminal.
Me?
Yes, I beg of you. We'll take care of the investigation, but we need you to come along to make the arrest.
I'm not sure.
This sounds like more trouble than it's worth, but I guess the station will make me do it later, even if I refuse right now. If that's the case, then it'd be easier for me if I did this my way. All right, I'll help. Really? Thank you. Thank you, Tanamura-san. By the way, I have no problem with arresting the criminal, but you guys don't have guns, right? Isn't that dangerous? I don't usually carry a gun. A police officer's job is to capture criminals, not kill them. If that's true, you've done a good job staying alive. Don't you have dangerous cases? Jeez. I may not look it, but I pack a pretty strong punch, stronger than any of the gangs here. Really? I wouldn't have guessed. I can't win a head-on slugfest with men, though. I use their own strength against them. So you're good at parrying, I guess. I prefer countering to simple brawls, too. So I can understand your logic. Oh yeah? We should try sparring together, then. Sparring? Yeah. That way we can share techniques and help each other get better. Sparring is important no matter what martial art you practice. I don't know if my style could be called a martial art, but alright. While we spar, you can update me on the progress of the investigation. Sounds great. You can come here anytime and I'll fill you in. Okay, when I have time then. Oh yeah, I was meaning to ask you something else. Have you heard of Revelations? Oh boy, here we go. Revelations? Yeah, I heard there are times you can have epic revelations just by witnessing certain special events throughout the city. People like us that train regularly can use that inspiration to discover new techniques. Revelations, huh? I think I understand, but I'm not sure how it works. When you witness the perfect shot, make sure to record it somehow. At least that's what someone told me. I've been keeping memos of the various new things I've seen since coming to Japan, and already have some technique-worthy material. That's interesting. I'll try using the notepad I always carry next time I see something. Worth a try. I'll keep an eye out for things around town, too. Anyways, sorry to ask so much of you. I may not be here for long, but I appreciate your help. Okay, we're gonna go hunting for the stuff, because it's usually amusing. Oop, wrong one. Yeah, it's Mac, okay. First, we have a girl asking for donations in the hotel district. Okay. A flirty couple tries their hand at UFO at Club Sega in Theatre Square. Danger in West Park. Okay. I know where all of these are. I don't have to keep referring to it. Where the fuck am I? There we go. Okay. Sorry, this dude's story takes place in alleyways that haven't existed in the other games, so... Okay, West Park is the closest one. These are worth doing. Oh, is this it? I think this is it. Okay, hang on. What a dick. This is like some Looney Tunes shit. What could I possibly learn from this? Okay. That's what it led to. Full of himself, a man made a high school girl cry, but in the end, it was his own deeds that brought about his downfall. A surprise attack to the head from one's blind spot can knock somebody out. It's a revelation. Okay. Sega... Oh, no, Hotel District. It's, like, back this way. Yeah, I mean, talk shit, get hit, right? Is this the place? Hey, is this the Dragon Palace? Oh, right, I was supposed to come here. Get out of here, kid. Yeah, beat it. Don't know nothing about no Dragon Palace. You sure about that? Oh, I'm sure. All right. Wait a second, young man. Hmm? Why are you looking for the Dragon Palace? I just have a few expenses I need to cover. Why do you ask? I was thinking you can help me out. If you do, I'll show you into the Dragon Palace. You will? Come on, boss. You're not really going to show him, are you? That's a trade secret. Yeah, and besides, I don't like the look of this kid. Now, don't be like that. Besides, we do need a little help, don't we? The truth is, some customers ran off without paying their tabs. I'm sure a young fellow like you could catch them. Do you have any idea where they could be? I have their pictures and descriptions right here. There's three of them. The first is a lawyer named Akune. He's a really fast runner. He slips right away when you think you got him. He's sometimes seen in the underground parking lot. The second is a surgeon named Kame. He may be a doctor, but he's an avid kickboxer too. He even beat the hell out of our buddy Nori-san the other day. He's sometimes seen in the Champion District. The third person is Maria. She owns a high-end club. She uses her vast wealth to hire a group of tough-looking bodyguards. She's always around the Millennium Tower, but we can't get anywhere near her. That'd only get us beaten to a pulp. Do you have any questions? No, I think I got it. Akune, Kame, and Maria. Great. We'll be waiting here for you. Yeah, I'll go do that in a minute. Right now, I'm looking for the revelation. That, okay. Gotta stand back so we're inconspicuous. Oh, it's here. Okay. Gee, I wonder what's going to happen. This is so stupid.
Arigatou gozaimashita. Kochira, o tsukai kudasai.
Excuse me, what is she handing him? What is she handing him? I don't want... Because it kind of looked like she was handing a condom, but... Yeah, okay. But it could be something else. Desperate to catch the runaway 500 yen coin, the man quickly thrust his hand backwards between his legs. This generated amazing torque and he fell to the ground. If only I could apply this technique. It's a premium Lello condom. I don't want to think that. She's just a schoolgirl, right? I don't know. I can't tell. But the packaging did look like that. Then, alright, let's say it is a condom. What the fuck is she collecting donations for? The transaction is, here, have a complimentary condom. Thank you for your donation. Okay, it's here. Let's just... Who is it? It's them, but... The prompt isn't here. Okay, hold on. What did it say on it? Hang on. Flirty couple tries their hand at the UFO catcher. Okay, then it's in here. Hey, virtual hugging, how's it going? Bingo.
No? Oh, that was...
That one wasn't as, I mean, I suppose they're not trying to be funny. Okay. So, okay, that's totally what you learnt by seeing that, yep. That's the lesson. Makes perfect fucking sense. Okay, well, that's all three. You got a 24-hour shift, jeez. Good luck. Alright, let's pick up some of these side quests. Did he just learn how to fight from seeing a malfunction machine flip a toy? Yes. He also learned how to fight from someone donating to a woman that then proceeded to hand over a condom to that person that donated. There's been a chain of car break-ins around here lately. What? You can't be serious. Car break-ins, huh? Well, that sucks. I guess if I see one happening, I'll need to arrest whoever's responsible. Okay. Wait, what the fuck's going on over here? What? What the fuck? Huh? What is going on over here? This is just, it's not a quest or anything, it's just this NPC that's just in this corner, out of breath. Okay. Hey, look at that sweet ass bag. Bet we could make a fortune off that.
People are so careless. If they want us to steal that bag, we're happy to oblige. Hey, we're gonna be eating good tonight.
Those must be the guys behind all those recent car break-ins. I'd rather not deal with this crap, but I'll get my head chewed off later if I leave the scene of the crime in progress. If I charge in and run, it'll be too much of a hassle. I should approach quietly so they don't notice me. What do you mean, approach quietly? Do you mind? Okay, but I guess talk? Huh? I won't open.
What do you mean? The other one opened without a hitch.
Hey, what are you guys up to?
Huh? Oh, we can't get this lock to open. Why won't it budge? Come on!
Oh, a remote control key, huh? Maybe it needs a new battery.
Battery? You might be right. Hey, go to the store and get a new battery. Gotcha. But you have to pay for half, okay? I got it. Alright, let's try this again. Come on. Come on. It worked. You're a genius, man. You really helped us out, pal. We appreciate it.
Great.
By the way, what's your name?
Tanamura of the Kamurocho Police.
Oh, cool. You work for the police. That's... Wait a minute. Wouldn't that mean... You're a cop?
You bet I am.
Haha. You almost had me for a minute, man. Nice one.
Do you want to see my badge?
Haha. no, thank you.
So, you unlocked the door. Is that all you were planning on doing?
Well, what the hell are we supposed to do now? A cop is onto us. Oh, man. This is awful. It's gonna bust us for sure. Okay, let me try something. Officer!
Yeah?
It's true. We were trying to steal the wallet from this car. You caught us fair and square. Hey! Truth is, we already stole another wallet earlier.
Oh, yeah?
Yesterday, too, and the day before that. We're the thieves everybody's been talking about all over town. Yeah, that's us. There. We were honest. We told you everything.
Yes, you sure did.
Doesn't that mean anything to you? Your heart isn't moved at all?
Huh? What do you mean?
I tried to get him to take pity on us, but it didn't work. No, wait. Let me try. Please, listen, officer.
I've done enough listening. It's time for...
You just gotta hear me out. I'm begging ya.
Okay then.
We had no choice. No choice, I tell ya. He's right. This was the only thing we could do with our lives.
Really now?
What do you mean we had no choice? I don't know, man. It just popped out. What?
Enough already. Just follow me to the station.
Shit! We're gonna get arrested. I guess there's no avoiding it now. We ain't going anywhere. We don't give up that easily. What? Are you serious? Ah, fuck it. Let's just get him. Ah!
What is this game? It's Yakuza. That's what it is. Just... It's a very serious story with utter nonsense in between with the side stories. It's almost wrestling.
Man, this guy is strong. Yeah, this cop's no joke. He's the real deal.
Come on, guys. You know us cops don't have a lot of time on our hands. Please don't make any more work for us.
Yeah, but officer, you'd be out of a job without criminals like us. You wouldn't want that to happen, right? Yo, wait a minute. If everybody became a good citizen, just think what a great place Kamurocho would be for everybody. Hey, you got a point. Yeah, we should start a movement. We won't do anything bad anymore, and that'll set off a chain reaction. Soon, all of Kamurocho will change. Dude, that's a great idea. I'm glad I chose to team up with you. I made the right choice for sure. Thank you, I mean it, man. Let's start right away.
We're still going to the police station, you know that, right?
Right, sorry.
Man, what a royal pain in the... excuse me. Yes? This car? It's mine. Is there something I can help you with? Oh, this yours? I apologize, I'm from the KPD. I just caught a couple of men trying to break into your car. They were what? Is my car all right? Oh, it looks unscathed. What a relief. There have been a lot of break-ins lately. Take care, okay? Oh, thank you. Officer, please, take this. It's not much, but I want to reward you for your effort. Thank you again. Did they go to the police station by themselves? No, the screen fades to black. Anything could have happened. When the screen fades to black, anything can happen. Anything. Dude could have become a multi-billionaire and then blew all his earnings on a single horse race and then on the way back took him to the police station. Okay, so... Fuck. I keep forgetting that this guy can run into random idiots on the street. Oops. It just doesn't happen as often as the other characters, but... Whatever, that's fine. Yeah, I mean, I don't generally read that text. It's always the fucking same. Okay, there's someone that hangs around the tower. Let's see. She should be with two guards. I don't see her. Unless they mean inside this part here. Wait, that guy, you did your job. Let me give you my most precious family heirloom. I mean, is it any different than Americans and their typical culture? Oh, no, this is it. You did your job. Let me subsidize the company you work for. That's Maria. Gosh. Almost looks like she wants people to know her. Are you Maria-san? Hmm? Who's this little boy? Freeze, motherfucker! Oh, you can let him be. He's actually kind of cute. Heh. So, can I help you with something? You don't seem like such a bad guy. I need you to pay your tab at the Dragon Palace. Oh, that's why you're here? Well, too bad. Why don't we just forget that little matter and have ourselves some fun? Honestly, I probably wouldn't mind, but don't you think you should pay people what you owe? It's only fair. I suppose You certainly are a brave boy, so I guess there's no more room for negotiating?
I guess not.
In that case, I have no choice. Gentlemen, I want him out of my sight. What the fuck is this? Okay, so they're Americans, right? Like, she has the men in black guarding her for whatever reason. These voices.
Yeah!
I learned that from a fucking claw game. Take that. Jeez. This dude's a cop as well. I mean, it's taken a few games to realize that the fighting in this is basically wrestling. But you're just a boy. You're about ready to give up now. Hey, you got one. Keep up the good work. One down, two to go. Okay. The other one was underground car park, I think. Oh, and Champion District, so I guess I should go this way. Okay, there's one thing that... Do I have enough money? Yeah, I have enough money now. There's one thing that's kind of piquing my curiosity, and I'm gonna find out. Plus, what the fuck? It's gonna make some content. I'll do that later. That's another side story. Where was it? It should be here. Or am I wrong? Yeah. Okay. Does this actually work? Oh, no, it works. Okay. Alright. I'll do the super VIP massage course and get rid of all my money, please. I guess I'm only doing this for those that are unfamiliar with this. I hope you weren't waiting long. Hi, I'm Momiyama. So good to meet you. Don't worry, I'm going to make sure you get lots of special treatment, my succulent Hercules. Right this way, don't be shy now. We're gonna play a mini game. I'm not gonna explain it, you just watch. Oh dear. Alright, that's the majority of my money gone, so yeah. Okay, said the other one was near my Champion District area. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, dude was just getting a massage. But now I was curious if he had to do all the other courses. Because the way it works, like, you get massaged by a pretty girl, and then if you go there 10 times, you get made a VIP. And so you go to the VIP massage, and it's that guy. And the minigame just becomes extremely difficult at that point. I think I blew like 100,000 yen trying to complete the minigame. Oh, there he is. Hey, I think that's Kame. Kame!
What? Who are you? How do you know me?
I'm from the Dragon Palace. It's time to pay your tab.
Hmm. I had to beat down that old man just the other day. I guess I'll never learn. They don't call me Dr. Badass for nothing, you know? I guess you'll soon find out.
You saw a baby way more than a massage. The baby was because I am a sad baby and didn't get to finish the game. That's why. It's a way to express disappointment. You show a child. How do you get up after getting hit by a bicycle, honestly?
That was amazing!
Why'd you have to make it so difficult? I hate that it puts you back here. Looking good, kid. You're almost there. One more to go, huh? Oh my god. I can't wait to get back to the modern games where this doesn't happen. Gave me like less than half a second to react. Okay. Jeez.
Anyone else?
Okay. There are 9 Yakuza games, including Yakuza, and more spin-offs, and I'm planning to play all of them. I mean, I have Yakuza 0 to... Wait. To Yakuza 6, and then Like a Dragon. So I do have all of them, practically. I spread them out, like I played 3 of them last year, and then I've played 3 and 4 this year. I'll probably take a break from them and then do 5 at some point this year again. Well, if there's 9 of them and I don't have them, I think I have... Well, there is no Yakuza 7, like, there's Yakuza 6, and then there's Yakuza Like a Dragon, which is a spin-off, and then they're making Yakuza 8, or 7, I can't remember. Wait, how do I go? Oh, down here. The fuck's going on here? I forgot what the last dude looks like. Was it him? Hang on. Yeah, it is. Okay, I thought so. Google never lies. Yeah, but it's one of them hasn't been released yet, and the other one is like a dragon, which doesn't have a number. So, yeah. Okay, hey, your name is Akune, right? Hmm? And you are? You have a tab to sell at the palace, pal. Shit! You're from the Dragon Palace? I thought it was just a bunch of old dudes. Where did they find you? Heh. If you want me to pay up, you're gonna have to catch me first. And I'm the fastest lawyer in town. Oh no. Okay. Well. Well, what? What do you mean? You'll stand your ground even if you're wrong. Ah, that's the spirit. Spoken like a true American. Okay. For fuck's sake. For fuck's sake.
Get back here! Yes!
No, he got away. For fuck's sake. One more.
Gotcha!
Damn, I can't believe the last time I lost was when I was humiliated in high school 20 years ago. Well, whatever. You're gonna have to come with me. Amazing work, kid. You got them all. Time for you to live up to your end of the bargain. Of course, and we've prepared a little bonus for you as well. Yeah, take this to your friend who was stupid enough to put up his restaurant for collateral. 2 mil- What? What the fuck? Oh, right, the quest. Yeah. How did you know about that? Don't underestimate us just because we're homeless. We have eyes and ears across this whole city. Apparently. But are you really sure about all this? It's a lot of money. No worries. If these three had gotten away, we would have lost a great deal more. Alright, I feel like I owe you one now, but thank you very much. And you're welcome at the Dragon Palace anytime too. Swing on by sometime. Thanks. Will do. You guys spend it at the massage parlor? No, because the game's going to take me back immediately and have me hand it off to the rightful owner. Thank you so much. Wow, you're so handsome and reliable. Perhaps I should just get rid of this loser here and marry you instead. Hey. Well, thanks to you, I found a new place to come up on some quick cash, so I'd say it worked out perfectly. See, that's why I didn't want to tell you. You really saved our hides here. Please accept this with my gratitude. A copy of Explosive Fishing? What? What do you mean, explosive fishing? What does that mean? Nachan, help! It's Dad, you gotta help Dad. What's wrong? They took him away! They did? What happened? These scary guys burst into Homeland and harassed us about a woman named Nadine. Do you know who they were? No, but I think they were headed somewhere off Senryo Avenue. Please, Nachan, you gotta save my dad. Don't worry, I'll get him back in one piece. You just head back to the restaurant where it's safe. Okay? No, I'm going too. I had a feeling you were going to say that. Fine, but we've got to hurry. Think you can keep up? Of course I can. By the way, Marchan, I bought these for you in case you were tired. Hope you like them. Ow. What can I put away? Oh, yeah, that. Okay. Fuck. Okay. I gave away 2 million yen for a book. Well, it was his money to begin with. I was getting his money back. Senryo Avenue? What? It's not that I gave away my money. The whole point of that quest was to get his money back. Okay, this is Senryo Avenue. Is it supposed to be obvious? Okay.
Oi.
How many times do I have to tell you? I don't know any Nadine. But in no hurry, old man. How about we take a trip to our office and jog your memory there? I have nothing to say to you. Now keep your filthy hands away from me. Come on, guys. Do I really need to remind you of the legal ramifications for abduction? Are you actually that dumb? Who the hell are you? Does it matter? All you need to know is I'm taking Zhao-san back. This might get dangerous, Mei-Hua. Hang tight here for a minute. Alright, assholes. Let's see what you got. Oh no. It's one of those annoying ones, I think. I heard the sound, now I'm worried. No, okay, it's fine. There's a particular sound effect one of the NPC fighters make that means they just keep grabbing you repeatedly. That was a pretty cool finisher. That was from the condom dude. Hey, they hurt you any? No, I'm fine. We didn't mean to get you involved. They're looking for a woman named Nadine, right? Excuse me. Is she your buddy or something? Nadine came from the Philippines to seek better financial opportunities, but the authorities found out she was working illegally and now they're trying to chase her down. Then she sought help from the Asian Gateway, I'm assuming. Correct. She was actually at the restaurant at the time those thugs showed up. Luckily, she was in the back room, so she got the hell out of there as soon as she heard the commotion. Alright, then who were those people just now? Not the authorities? That's for sure. My guess is they're responsible for bringing illegal immigrants into the country. In other words, human traffickers. They must be afraid that if Nadine gets arrested, she'll lead the police right back to them. That makes sense. But I doubt she'll be coming this way anymore. Gonna be a real pain in the ass to find her. There is one method you can try. Yeah? I'm all ears. So, there's this fortune teller over on Tenkaichi Street. Maybe she could help you track Nadine down. A fortune teller? Is that seriously the best you can come up with? Or were you just kidding? Oh, it's no joke. In fact, this lady is known for being freakishly accurate in her predictions. Kinda spooky, if you ask me. It sure sounds spooky, but whatever. You're the one who's recommending it. I guess I have nothing to lose. Where's this place exactly? Middle of Tenkaichi Street, right next to a host club called Stardust. Okay. Here's hoping fortune's on our side, huh? If this is the same one from the previous game... There was a scam artist, and, we opted to let karma handle things. I think Tenkaichi Street is the main one over here. No! No, that's Nakamichi. Then Tenkaichi is the next one. This is Alley, so then the next one should be Tenkaichi Street. Okay, there we go. I don't see anyone that fits the description. Ah. What? Where did you even come from? Okay. Yeah, hurry up. Wait, is it pointing to here? No, just ignore it for now. The fuck's going on over there? Okay. No, so... What? She's not here. Unless they mean... No, but this is the alley. What do they sound like? Troglodytes? Who? Who sounds like a troglodyte? What are you looking at? Oh, right. This dude, like, just in awe. I don't know. I don't see any fortune teller here. Yeah, I think this dude's just, yeah, a memo guy. Doesn't do anything. Oh, the people that I fought last. Yeah, I don't know.
You can upgrade your abilities.
Sure. Let's just get one of the more expensive skills. That'll do. Some stories. The psychic near Stardust on Tenkaichi Street. Okay, so this is Stardust. Where the fuck is she? They don't... There's someone... They're lining up for something. Okay, let's stand in front of Stardust and let's look with the camera, maybe... Maybe it's one of these things we have to spot out. Yeah, I don't really see anything that fits the description of fortune teller. Alright, how about this? Let me go in a building and come back out. Maybe it needs to register. I mean, it would have to be here. This is Stardust over here. Alright, let's go in the store and just come back out. Alright, so here we are, Stardust. I'm gonna hate this. The answer's gonna be minor and obvious. Wait, there's a blue square here. What is this blue square? Naomi's place. Okay, I think this is it. Welcome, welcome. What can Naomi's amazing psychic powers do for you today? I'm looking for a Filipino woman who's gone missing. Her name's Nadine.
Nadine, you say? Was she your sweetheart? She must let go of what is gone. Accepting the inevitable is simply a part of life, young man.
Are you going to help me or not? My friend Zhao-san over in Little Asia said you have the power to see the unseen.
Yes, but my services do not come cheap, Detective Tanimura.
You know who I am?
What sort of psychic would I be if I didn't at least know that? Naomi sees all. Knows all.
Right. Okay, then. Do you know where Nadine is? What are you doing?
Silence. The great and powerful Naomi must concentrate. Yes, yes, I see a name. Saki-chan. You should go ask Saki-chan.
Saki-chan?
She will give you the information you seek.
You're not giving me the runaround, are you?
If you do not trust my powers, you can take your business elsewhere.
Fine. Just tell me where I can find Asaki-san. Chan.
Near Pink Street. She'll be wearing a purple scarf.
Thanks. If this goes well, you'll have yourself a new customer.
Come again.
Okay. Let's see if I can find Pink Street. I think I know which Pink Street. I gotta learn the names. I've played this game how many times? I still haven't completely learnt the street names. I know the general direction of things and where major things are. You were lurking peacefully until you heard me say Sucky. No, Saki. This isn't like an Oni-chan situation. It's fine. Just lurk peacefully. That's Senryo. Pink Street is like somewhere near here. You hear what you want to hear. Yeah, that's North Pink Street. Okay, so then... this is Pink Street. Okay, woman in a scarf. That's a purple scarf. Is it her? I said Saki, admit it. Tried to correct yourself. Well, I say it with a Australian accent. I'm sorry I don't put like the A as Americans would say it. Wait, so also purple purple scarf. So that's
Sa-ki.
You happy? Well, I guess no one explicitly said what kind of woman she'd be. And a purple scarf. Couldn't have gotten some other clue, even an accessory that anyone could wear isn't exactly a distinguishing feature. Hey there, would you happen to be
Sa-ki?
Chan? Oh, hey there yourself. Don't tell me you were about to use a pickup line, weren't you? Isn't he adorable, folks? Actually, I'm looking for somebody. A woman named Nadine.
Oh, shit!
Hey, get back here. It's another chase scene, is it? Damn it, I don't have the music queued up. Alright, just listen. Insert Mario 64 music here, that's fine. I have to say it like I don't have free healthcare. Oh, well, let me go injure myself then and not get medical attention. BRB. Oh shit. Oh my god. These inputs.
Blech.
Nice. Look. I think you got the wrong idea. I'm not after Nadine. In fact, I'm trying to help her. Are you really? Cross my heart. So what's up with this whole chase sequence as soon as you saw my badge? Are you hiding something? Well, the thing is, I help people. Help them how? I use my connections to help foreign women when the cops or criminals come for them. So, I take it you know Nadine, then? What would you do if you found her? Let me put it this way, she'll be dead if I don't find her first, and I'd like to get her home safe before that happens. Alright, I know where she is. I'm actually the one looking after her. Great. Can you take me to see her, then? Well, you do seem like a decent guy. All righty poo, you can just follow me. Wait, you thought it was a part of the game. How could I? Made you joyful for 4 minutes while I was in that chase scene for a sham, a cover-up. Hey, my production value was good enough that I perfectly lined up that music to start up as the countdown was happening, and then I even did the audio fade out by panning the YouTube volume down to make it seem legit. Come on. My commitment is unquestionable. So you're Nadine? Yes. He says he's here to help you, dear. Really? Yep. Had a heck of a time trying to find you, too.
Oh, I'm yawning.
Nice work. She's not out of trouble just yet. Those creeps have her passport and she can't get home without it. You mean the human traffickers? I take it you've run into them already. Well, it's not the only trafficking they'll do. They're in charge of managing the women they bring in, too. Managing? In what sense? They take these women's passports so they can't escape, and then they give them just enough money to eke out a meager living. They're essentially modern-day slave drivers. Ugh, that's terrible. I hate bastards like that the most. You have any idea where they are? In a dilapidated food warehouse on the docks. I want to go home to the Philippines. Don't worry, we'll get your passport back. You will? Yep. Just leave it to me. I made it too real. Okay, like, if you truly believe that Super Mario 64 music would play in a game about Japanese gangsters, that's on you. Yes, Miyamoto was an executive producer on the Yakuza series. Okay. Oh, it's daytime here now. I imagine this is the door. Food warehouse in the docks, huh? Then those must be the guys who took Nadine's passport. Excuse me, I'm here for the passports you've been stealing from foreign women.
Wait a minute, aren't you?
Yeah, you bet I am. If you don't want to get hurt again, hand over the passports and make it quick.
You're one cocky son of a bitch, you know that? Alright, you're up. Come on out.
Oh, what? What the hell do you feed this guy? Me? Milk? Beef? Growth hormones?
Now pulverize this punk.
You don't know if Nintendo let the devs use it in this game. Does Nintendo let anyone use anything? Yes, they have. They have a track record of letting people use stuff. Remember that time when Nintendo let the developers of Chainsaw Lollipop use Mario? It was a great crossover. You know, the zombies would come, there'd be a girl in a cheerleader outfit, massive cleavage, and Mario would be bing bing wahoo! you know, just in the background there. Especially content creators. Nintendo has always been nice to them. Yeah, totally. How many times must I say it? Give me the passports.
Fine, just take the damn things.
Just to let you know, I got a call from Nadine this morning. She got home safe and sound. Good to hear. I hope this means fewer migrant workers like her will suffer through that same shitty experience. I don't mean to be a sourpuss, but even though you busted up those jerks at the warehouse, this kind of thing will still go on. Why do you say that? Because men like that are everywhere. They're only after one thing, the almighty yen. They'll stop at nothing to get it, even if it means ruining countless lives. But there has to be someone at the top pulling the strings. You're saying there's a mastermind of the sex industry? A ringleader making millions off the lives of female migrant workers? Awful as that is, that doesn't sound too far-fetched. Right. Every power structure has a person in charge. You have any leads on where this ringleader might be? Not really, but I have heard those traffickers drop the name Bridge before. That could be a clue. Wait, did you just say Bridge? Oh, you know him? My dad left notes about someone named Bridge all throughout his notebook. Sorry, I probably should clarify what I mean by that. No need, I know all about you, Detective Tanimura of the KPD. How did you... I heard about you from Naomi-san, the fortune teller. Tell me, what specifically did your father's notebook say about Bridge? Apparently Kay and my dad were investigating him. And who is Kay? Another detective who worked for my dad, but damn, I never would have guessed that Bridge was some sort of sex trafficking kingpin. This could get ugly. Do you intend to find this Bridge and expose him? Oh yeah, especially if this is the same guy my dad was after. Still, don't have any idea who Kay is, though. Have you done your research? I looked up all the detectives who ever worked the case with my dad. None of their names started with Kay. I already know who Kay is. I already know. Or at least I can guess. And there's no file on Bridge either. I think Kay and my dad were investigating Bridge off the record. You know, the more you look into this, the more you're going to uncover about your past. What are you trying to say? Taiki Tanimura was my senior detective.
You were a detective?
Judging from what you just said, I'm sure you know Taiki wasn't my actual dad, right? Mm-hmm. Then you know who my real dad is? I can't comment on that. All I can say, if you don't want to get hurt by what you find, I suggest you leave this case alone. I won't get hurt. That's impossible.
Oh?
See, no matter who my real dad is, I'm still going to be the same guy. Let the past be the past, you know? By the way, why do they call this guy Bridge? Couldn't tell you, hun. I see. Well, I guess this is just one more case my dad left me to solve. No matter what, I'm going to find this Bridge and bring his ass to justice. Yeah, if I was to take a guess, Kay is Kiryu. Because Kiryu did work with police in Yakuza 0. Or at least some detective. From what I remember. Which would then bring him into the story, because he's only appeared at the start, so... It makes sense. Time to get 100 million from the car in the parking lot. Alright, let's do that. Let's do the main story. Homicide. A murder. Aw, man. No, what now? Tanamura here.
You listening to your radio? Get your ass over here now.
I don't get it. Why are you calling me about this?
I didn't say for you to ask questions. Just get over here now.
Yeah, yeah. Be right there. What the hell? Oh well. Guess I'll head over to the Mac Bowl. Well, never mind. But yeah, I mean, I imagine the final chapter is with Kiryu, so... Would make sense. He hasn't really had too much of a role so far. It's the next street, right? Yes, next street. I haven't been tempted by the food posters today. Oh, camera. Hey! Camera, please. There we go. I was walking into a bicycle. Wait, no, this is the batting cage. My bad. It's the bowling center? Wait, where's the bowling center? Oh, wait. I think I know where it is. I don't do sports. I confuse bowling with batting. It's my bad. They both start with B. They both have a ball. Hey, I'm here. Yeah, so this is the Stiff's a writer. Wait, so the Stiff's a writer for the sex industry. Since you seem to be an expert on the subject, I thought you might have some dirt on him. Did you call me out here just to give me shit? Oh, and what was his name again? Make an effort to remember what you hear on the dispatch, Tanamura. His name is Koichi Yabe. 35 years old. Huh? Don't know who that is. You sure about that? I'm telling you, I've never heard of him. All right, then. Thanks. You can go now. The murder victim was a sex industry writer. Something stinks about this. Tanamura here. Hey, it's me. Hey, Saki-chan.
Saki!
I heard Yabe was killed. Not bad for a former detective. You got your info quick, so what do you know about this Yabe? I wanted to talk to you about that. Let's meet at Shellac. Okay, Shellac it is. Seiki. It doesn't have an A. It doesn't have a Y in it. Huh? doing my best to avoid these battles. Wait. Am I in the correct spot? I think so. Please, no battle. Okay, I've done a good job avoiding it. Oh, that's Earth Angel, not Shellac. Wait, Shellac? Oh, Shellac is... yeah. Yeah. Oh, hi, hon. Turns out Yabe-san was on the cusp of something dangerous. What was it he investigated? Not what, but who? A woman from Hong Kong. Huh? I take it she's not just some random lady? Right. Rumor has it she has some-
to hear it.
Shut up, Siri! What did I even say to- oh, whatever. I don't know if you heard- yeah, anyway. Right, rumor has it she has ties to a certain crime syndicate. And she's in charge of illegal immigrant workers, all of them female. So, she's a crime boss then. And this syndicate's supposed to be? A powerful underground intelligence network spread throughout Asia. Apparently they recruit girls from poor families and make them buy fake passports and... bizza! They force them to work like slaves to work off the loans used to buy them. And when they used up their history. Don't tell me. Bridge is the one running the show? That's my guess. Any idea where this crime boss lady might be? I'm not entirely sure, but I hear the syndicate has an office near the arcade in Nakamichi Alley. I'm sure this goes without saying, but be careful, okay? Thanks, I'll try.
That's good to hear.
Alright, since I'm out here, I may as well see what this is.
What are you taking a picture of? Give me that camera. Now we're gonna have a little chat right over here.
I'm sorry, I've never seen real Japanese Yakuza before. I just got a little excited, perhaps too carried away.
Oh yeah? Then just follow us, we'll teach you everything you ever wanted to know about Japan.
Hey, he said he's sorry, just let him go.
Hey, you mind your own damn goddamn business? Unless you want in on what we're about to teach this fucker.
Picking on a civilian and a tourist at that? Where's your sense of honor?
You little shit! What the hell would you know about how we operate? Maybe we ought to educate you first.
Okay. I do like this dude's theme music. It's very Cowboy Bebop-like.
Bicycle warfare!
Yeah. That was pretty fluid.
Shit! Let's get a move on, boys! Wow, bruh, that just blew my mind. That was real Aikido just now. You are like a samurai out there taking out those dudes. Rock on, brother man.
I understand this is all new to you and all, but why don't you put away the camera? It's not a good idea in this town.
Oh, snap, that means you're a local, which by definition means you're familiar with the area, yes?
Well, yeah, why?
Bam! Look at that sick karma payoff right there. It's gotta be fate, you know, running into my new tour guide like this.
Buddy, your logic is loopy. And who said I'd be your tour guide? I've got stuff to take care of.
Oh no! Come on! I'm sure you have at least some time to guide a helpless foreigner who doesn't know their right from their left in a totally unfamiliar city. That'd be irresponsible. So why not take a chance and point me where I need to be? Am I not overly friendly enough? Besides
what?
I'll give you a fat tip. To be blunt, I'm filthy rich.
Fine.
Alright, I guess I could show you around, but only for a little while, okay?
Oh, so you're going for it after all, huh? Nice. Should have brought up the prospect of money a little sooner, huh? Anyway, I'm Smith. Super honored to meet you, man.
Likewise, I'm Tanamura. So, where is it you want to go?
I came all the way to Japan, so I want to see something really Japanese, you know?
Japanese, huh? Is there anything specific you're interested in?
There is, but I completely forgot the name of it. Let's see, what was it called?
You tell me. Maybe try describing it the way I can see, at least I can get an idea of what you want.
Okay, well, it's a place people compete one-on-one in a traditional intellectual tabletop game.
A game?
Yeah, didn't I pronounce that right? A traditional one-versus-one tabletop battle of intelligence? I hear it's a game for everybody. Men, women, boys, girls, you name it.
Well, it could be one of several things, but you're probably talking about...
How about Shoten on Senryu Avenue? Huh? What's a Shoten?
Somewhere that fits your description perfectly. I'm sure that's the place you mean.
Yeah? You are... I don't know, man. Your confidence is pretty unnerving. But fuck it. Let's go check it out anyway.
Well?
Yes! This is it! This is exactly what I was talking about. What's the name of this game again?
It's called Shogi.
That's right, Shogi. The tension in here is so thick you could cut it with a knife. This is some good shit, my dude.
Well, you sound satisfied. I'm happy for you, so is it cool if I leave now?
Well, if you wouldn't mind kicking it with me for a little longer, there is one more place I want to go, but that's it.
Might as well see this through. Fine. Where to?
I want to go somewhere where only men are allowed. I'm not quite sure I get it. You know what I mean. I forgot the exact name. Let's see here. It's a place where it's men only, and everybody is naked. They rub shoulders and communicate with each other. Something like that.
Drawing a total blank here.
Oh, come on. You know what I mean. A men's only place where everybody's naked. Japan is known for this shit.
Well, you could be talking about a... Then let's go to Unisono Hot Springs.
Unisono Hot Springs?
Yeah, a hot spring is the place to be if you want to get naked and communicate with other men.
Sounds good to me. Let's get cracking. Wow, legit Japanese hot spring. Now this is what I'm talking about. Let's get naked and jump right in, Tanamura-san. You're coming in too, right?
No, I think I'll sit this one out.
Alrighty, well, I'll be back. Time to see some penis, what? Sorry to keep you waiting.
Finally. Wait, aren't those guys?
Yeah, those Yakuza from before. We ended up bumping into each other in the bath, and wouldn't you know it, we became total buds. Nothing like a hot, steamy mineral bath to wash away your differences, am I right? And now we're like family. Not like I actually joined their family, but you know what I mean. Ha ha. Get a load of this motherfucker. This guy's freaking hilarious. Man, I tell you, we'd all get along better if nobody wore any clothes at all. Tanamura-san, you've made this trip the trip of our lifetime. Please take this as a token of my appreciation.
Cringe American tourist PTSD.
Yeah.
Oh, that was great.
All right then, guess I'm going out for drinks with the boys right now.
I hope you're ready to drink till sunrise. He's even got the Ed Hardy jacket and everything. It's perfect. Okay. Right. Yeah, the car. The American accents in this are great. Because it's usually a Japanese voice actor trying to do an American accent. Okay, we've got an entry point over here. Right, so first to check cars. The boot of a car.
Hey, what are you doing to my ride?
Oh no, nothing.
Strange, there's been a string of break-ins around here these past few days. I bet it was you.
Trust me, it's not. Besides, do I look desperate enough to break into a bucket like that?
Hey! This ain't no bucket. It's vintage, damn it. It has its own sort of charm. You know what? Forget it. You just earned yourself an ass-kicking.
Yeah, this is gonna happen a lot. Because the last time I played this, it probably explained where to find said car, but, you know. That was, probably a week ago. So, now we're just gonna have to go around opening every single car. Oh, what the fuck was that?
Shit.
Also, I'm with the Tokyo PD. Probably should have mentioned that sooner.
What the hell? You mean I just picked a fight with a cop?
Yep, but it was partly my fault too. Don't worry. I wouldn't tell if you weren't.
That's a relief. We'll see you around, hopefully not soon.
Okay. I mean, thankfully it's not every single car. It's just ones that have the rear facing outwards. Okay, well, that's good.
It opened, and there's a briefcase just like Yasuka-san said.
Okay, I've got a briefcase loaded to the brim with yen. 100 million yen, to be in fact. This is good. All that's left is figuring out how to get in touch with Katsuragi. Oh yeah, right, Yasuko. Now what's the easiest way for a community safety officer to reach a powerful member of the Yakuza? Never thought I'd ask myself that. Well, it doesn't really give me a clue, does it? Hello?
Tanamura-san, right?
Yes, that's me. And you are?
Heh, that's not important. Let's just cut to the chase. You want info on Katsuragi, don't you?
How did you?
It's my job to know that sort of thing. As such, it works only to my benefit to funnel information to you.
That's fine, but why should I believe some random caller who could be a total scammer for all I know?
Good point, except you don't have anywhere else to turn right now, do you?
Not really.
That's what I thought. Now, do you want that information or not? Of course, you could always hang up and be on your way.
No, let's hear what you have to say.
Smart man. Only thing is, nothing in life is free.
What? You're giving me a quote already?
Everything has a price, officer. But I'm not interested in your money. I just want to see how good of a detective you are. You'll be receiving a message from me shortly. Open it up, read it, and follow the instructions. Very self-explanatory. Well, best of luck.
Hey, we're not done yet.
An informant awaits you where this site can be seen. Get there on the double. Clothes hang. It's on the roof somewhere. Okay. Now, if I was to, okay. It could be one of two ways. It could either be it's the nearest rooftop or it's going to be the furthest one away from me. I'm going to choose to think that this is like linear and it's going to put me on the nearest rooftop. Okay, let's see. It's not looking good. Wait, I see clothes. Clothes ahead. Okay, it looks like it's a normal prop. I don't think it's this one. This has multiple paths out. Okay. I guess this was the third door, so let's just go out this way. Oh, this keeps going up. Okay, let's try this rooftop over here. Oh, don't think I've been here before. Oh, it's the armor shop. Wait, isn't this the one that I came back from, or... Ah, this rooftop stuff. I'm gonna be back where I started, I imagine. Going down. Yeah, okay. So... let me have a look. So... I gotta go further across. I kinda figured it wouldn't be on the closest one, but... sometimes it is. Sometimes it's on the closest... because it wants to make the quest very linear, but this one, I guess, not walk the distance. Okay. Wait, isn't it here? Ah. That looks promising. Yeah, there's the tower. I can see the tower. Okay. That's it.
Are you Tanamura-san?
That I am. You the one who called me? I don't know anything about a call. My boss just told me to come here and give this to you. Here, take it. What's this for?
I don't know. Maybe you got a secret admirer? Either way, it's yours now. A bouquet of flowers? I don't get it. Wait, there's a note inside. It says, "Well done, Gumshoe. You take after your papa more than I expected. I suppose I should hold my end of the bargain. You'll be getting a call from Katsuragi soon. What you do next is up to you. Just see that you don't waste this chance." Hmm.
Kamurosho no Tanimura-san desu ne. どうして私に連絡を?あんたと取引がしたい。取引?実は今、冴島康子を俺が預かっている。警察にはまだ報告していない。あくまで俺が身柄を拘束している状態だ。なるほど。あんたが冴島康子を使って柴田組の連中を殺すよう命じていたことは分かっている。もちろん。 25年前の事件のことだな。あんたはまだ冴島康子が必要なはずだ。違うか?それで、私にどうしろと?俺は25年前の事件を追っている。事件を担当した谷村という刑事が死んだ理由、それが知りたい。もしかして息子さんですか?あの刑事さんの。あんたが取引に応じてくれれば、
冴島康子の身柄は渡せ。どうだ?25年前の真相を俺に教えてくれないか?条件があります。条件?私としても刑事さんであるあなたにうかつなことは話せない。それに電話ではあなたが冴島康子の身柄を拘束しているという確認もできない。あなたが冴島康子とつながっているという証拠を見せてください。わかった。
1億持っていこう。それでどうだ?
1億?
ああ。
あんたが安子さんに要求した1億だ。その金が今俺の手元にある。安子さんが用意したものだ。取引の際その金を持っていく。俺に合うのはその金を確認してからで構わない。それでどうだ。1億ですか。 1階の刑事さんがダミーとして集められる金額じゃない。いいでしょう。お会いしましょう。明日でどうだ。構いません。場所は？カムロ町。ミレニアムタワーの前で17時。<笑>どうやら頭のいい方のようだ。一番人通りの多い場所と時間。公衆の面前なら襲われる危険も少ない。いいでしょう。 5時、ミレニアムタワー前。先に使いの者に1億を確認させます。それでもいいですか？構わない。では明日。
I'm meeting Katsuragi tomorrow at 5 PM. I think I'll go rest at Homeland till then. Yeah, so what, is he betraying? No. I forgot what he was supposed to do with this money. Where does it want me to go? Oh, right. The Chinese district. I should just take this money and go to the massage parlor and try and beat that minigame. Wait, what the fuck? According to this- oh, there we go. It's just very dodgy. Okay, got it. Just all alleyways. Yeah, I should have gone the normal way. Oh, this is fucking convoluted. Nope, I have messed up here quite severely. I thought this would be a shortcut, but it is not. Oh my god. Wait, this doesn't let me go back down? Okay. I'm nearly there. There it is. Got it. Ah, Machan, how did it go? You find the briefcase? Yeah, took me long enough. Sure wish I'd... thought to ask Yasuko what her car looked like before she left. Anyway, I got a call from Katsuragi not long after that. We've set up to meet tomorrow. Really? You did? Wow, that's quite the breakthrough. I'm sure he's up to something, though. You better be prepared. I will be. In the meantime, you mind holding on to this briefcase for me? Hey, Machan, we have a customer waiting for you. Yeah? Who is it? A Filipino girl. She says she has a favor to ask. Will you at least hear her out? Alright, I'll head on over. Are you the person who needed some kind of favor? Oh, you're Tanimura-san. Yes, my friend talks about you. She says you're very kind. I wonder who that is. Anyway, tell me about yourself. I'm Faye, and I'm a hostess here in Kamurocho. Okay, and what is it you want? I want you to be my boyfriend. I'll do anything for you, anything. So, please be my boyfriend? Whoa, slow down there. What's all this boyfriend stuff about? You don't even know me. Does that mean you won't be my boyfriend? I don't know why you thought I would. Is there some kind of reason you're looking for a boyfriend so bad? Well, if you were my boyfriend, I thought maybe you could save me? Save you from what? Is somebody after you? There was a man I was dating who did some terrible things. Things that landed him in prison. But now he's back in Kamurocho, and the first thing he did was find me. He took all my money, which I need to send back home to the Philippines. I thought I'd never see him again, but he forced his way back into my life. That's why I need your help, Tanimura-san. Please be my new boyfriend, even if it's just for today, and make my old one go away. Let me get this straight. You're trying to ditch your loser of an ex, so you want me to pretend to be your man just so he'll get the message? Yes, I'd like you to talk to him and make him leave me alone. Please, just this once? Won't you be my boyfriend? Fine, I'll do it. Though I'm not quite sure how you want this to work. Thank you. You have no idea how much this means to me. As far as how to go about this, first, I need to call my ex-boyfriend and invite him to Shellac. You and I will be waiting there. Shellac? That's in the Champion District. Okay, got it. That's such a relief. I'll meet you there, okay? Please don't forget to show up. Well, guess I'd better get on over to Shellac. This should be fun. Ah, I thought it was going to take me there right away. Okay, it's nearby. It's fine. It's just killing some time until the main quest continues. Okay, that's Shellac. Did I keep you waiting? No, I just got here. Thanks for coming, Tanimura-san. Uh-huh. So, where's this man of yours? I had just called him. He should be here soon. Fine. We'll just have to wait then. So, what's this guy's name? Esawa, he was so nice to me when I first came here to Japan, but it wasn't long before he quit his job. Then he started taking all my money. I asked one of my customers if they could help me. He said yes. He even agreed to run away with me. But when Esawa found out, he attacked that customer and hurt him pretty bad. He's been in prison ever since. Wow. That sounds like a real nice guy. And he gets so aggressive whenever he's upset. He's not even afraid to hit someone. Welcome, sir.
So, Faye. This the new jock you're riding?
He's my boyfriend, Asawa. His name is Tanimura-san. So you're the guy she was dating? Look, Faye says she wants you out of her life, so I'm here to make sure that happens. Believe me, I'd rather not be here either.
Don't remember asking you to talk. How about you stay out of my shit and go be someone else's asswipe? Now, Faye, is this true? After all the kindness I've shown you, all the love I've given you, you still want to dump me? Are you really going to be an ungrateful bitch right now?
But you're always hitting me and spending what I earn on yourself. Tanimura-san, on the other hand, is kind. He only thinks of what's good for me.
Give me a fucking break. You like this smartass, twig-looking dipshit?
I've heard enough. You obviously can't take no for an answer. So let's take this outside.
Well, damn. Didn't know you had a sack between those scrawny-ass legs. Fine then. Get the fuck out that door.
Huh?
All right. You listen and you listen good. Faye's my girl. Only I know how to treat her like the lady she is. But you, compared to me, you're jack shit. And you're about to be dead meat.
All right, cool. Can I? No, can't milk crate him. Oh well. Yeah, really showing me there. Good job. Tanimura-san, are you okay? Are you hurt?
You serious, Faye? You ain't just fucking with me. Are you really trying to do me dirty like this? Fine, I'll just step back and let you think about it. But don't forget that you'll never make it without me. You're nobody going nowhere in life. Oh, and enjoy your new prick.
Are you okay? I am, now that it's over between Asawa and me. I can't thank you enough, Tanimura-san. Well, at least you got some sense knocked into him. But it's fairly obvious he's the type to hold a grudge. I should give you my number, so you can call me just in case. Yes, please do that. That's very thoughtful, Tanimura-san. Well, I'm off. Hope your money makes it back home safely from now on. Yes, oh, and before I forget, I'd like you to have this. A cold pack? Really? That's the reward? I guess this is goodbye. Maybe you can swing by my work in it sometime? Just a thought. A cold pack. Never thought it feels so good to be single. On that note, I should get back to work myself. Oh, you saved my life. You saved me from that thug that was taking all my money. Here, have a bag of frozen water. Huh? Someone's tailing me. Instead of trying to shake him, why don't I lead him into a trap? Yeah, he's still on my ass. Maybe I should give him the slip here.
Damn it! Where the hell did this guy go?
Hey, buddy. I know you're following me.
Son of a...
Oh, what do you know? You again?
Damn right it's me. You think I'm gonna let some dickhead just walk away with my woman? Yeah, fucking right.
So what, you came here to bitch and moan?
Hardly. I'm getting Faye back after I send your ass to the grave. That's all there is to it.
Oh yeah?
I've been through this before, see? Faye ran out on me with another dude and, let's just say I took care of the bastard. Should have done him in for good. So I brought a little something along to help ensure that mistake doesn't happen again. Ever seen a gun up close? Well, you're about to taste lead, motherfucker.
His eyes. Okay, well, yeah, it's the same thing again. Yeah, you ever see a foot up close? Let me demonstrate.
Shit, I had a goddamn gun. How the hell could this happen?
You, sir, are in violation of the gun control law, and I'm placing you under arrest. Really, what kind of idiot brings a piece to a fistfight in Japan of all places?
God damn it! It wasn't supposed to go down like this. Hey, this ain't over by a long shot. You mark my words.
What?
That is mine. I ain't letting anybody get on her hand.
Damn. That is in danger. I have to catch him before it's too late.
I couldn't be fucked reading it again. Yeah, but where did he go? Tanamura here.
Help! Help me!
Faye, where are you?
At work. Asawa's here.
Where is this place at?
North Pink Street. It's a club called Purple Moon.
Hey, who the hell are you talking to?
Yeah!
Purple something something, North Pink Street.
Damn, Misawa's already there.
Okay, Purple Moon, North Pink Street. Be right there. There's Pink Alley, and North Pink Street is over here. Excuse me, oh for fuck's, I thought it was him, but it's not. It's just another NPC that has a similar look. That is interrupting my quest. Dickheads. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, let's get rid of Torana. Purple Moon on North Pink Street, isn't it? No, it has to be somewhere here. Lounge. It's Club Asia. What? Where is this place? Sweet Lounge. North Pink Street. All right, it has to be one of these buildings. That Purple Moon, there it is. Here it is, Purple Moon. Am I ready to do this? Alright, I'm going in. Sawa's strapped, so I need to be careful how I approach him. A chase? You're not getting away. insert Mario 64 music here. They didn't press it quick enough. Shit. But it got him, didn't it? Yeah, it did. It did.
You're under arrest, Asawa. Now come along quietly.
Screw you. I just want to be with Faye. That's all I ever wanted. Why'd you have to fuck it all up?
Asawa, you're lost, man. Tanimura-san.
Faye, this isn't the life I wanted for us.
Never come near me again, understand? You stay away from me.
Hey.
Asawa, whatever kind of feeling you have towards Faye, I doubt it's actually love. If it was, she wouldn't be terrified of having you around.
Ugh. Tell me what I did wrong. Tell me why some jackass cop decided on a whim to go up and rip the love from my life. Yeah, I'm talking about you, you little shit stain. Your boy band looking ass ever loved a woman before? I'm guessing the answer's no. I mean, you clearly don't give a damn about Faye. You were pretending to be a boyfriend just to get at me, right? Oh, what a stand-up guy you are. Messing around with another man's girl just to feel better about your lonely, fucked up life.
Alright, pipe down. One more word out of you and we'll add obstruction of justice too.
Tanimura-san. It's over, Faye. Sawa's more than likely headed back to prison, and I'll have some officers patrol the area for the time being. I don't know how to thank you. You've done so much for me. Maybe this will express how I feel? Ah, Tanimura-san. I want to express my feelings. Here, have a chunk of wood.
Whatever. Yeah, straight to the item box.
Anyways, the boys will need some information from you back to the at the station. But I'll make sure they treat you good. Okay, I'll trust you, Tanimura-san. Oh, and one more thing. What is it? You really are a caring, honest person. Forget what Asawa said. Oh, nah, that kind of stuff doesn't faze me. Besides... Oh, but I appreciate it, Faye. Jeez, my reading's gone out the window. I just thought I'd let you know. Well, so long. Sawa, you don't know the first thing about me. I know who I am and what my heart is capable of, perhaps a little too well.
Can I go take a rest now?
For fuck's sake. It's from Homeland. Hello? Ma-chan! Meihua, what's up? I need you back at Homeland, hurry! Whoa, come down and tell me what's happened.
Just hurry back here now. Something's awful happened.
Okay, I'll be right there. I'm literally right outside. Yeah, okay. Like, I'm right here, dude. Oh, Ma-chan. I got here as quick as I could. What's going on? I've never heard you sound so worried over the phone before. The Asian Gateway money's missing.
What?
Gone missing? I think you mean we flat out got robbed. Ah!
You okay, Dad?
Yeah, Zhao-san, what happened?
These guys suddenly barged in and said, "Give us the money you're hoarding." I tried to say no. And that's why I look like this.
They raided the place in broad daylight, huh? Do you have any injuries? What about Meihua? I'm fine, and Meihua wasn't here. What a relief. Ma-chan, they left with this message. If you want your money back, tell the parasite of Kamurocho to come alone to the vacant lot across from Public Park 3. Parasite of Kamurocho? Even criminals are calling me that now? What an honor. Well, looks like it's me they're after. Ma-chan, we can save that money back up again. You don't have to... I do. They're after me, so if I don't go, this will happen over and over. But Ma-chan, it's too dangerous. I'll be fine. This sort of thing is nothing new to me. But the vacant lot across Public Park 3? That's far. Guess I'd better start walking. Don't hurt yourself, Ma-chan. Okay. I mean, I feel like this chapter's almost over. Wait, what? It's not even part of the main quest. What is Public Park 3 then? Lists. Okay, so I should have turned down that street. Got it. I'll see where it goes after this quest. I am getting a little tired. My voice is starting to give. Especially with that last dude, doing that extra deep voice, I don't know. Usually I can do it, but I guess I'm not up for it today. Behind the arcade, Bridge Syndicates should have an office around here. Should I go in? Alright. Okay, I'm going in.
Oh, and who might you be?
Doesn't matter, I'm looking for the boss. Some lady from Hong Kong. Don't know what you're talking about. Don't play stupid with me. Just bring her here and there won't be any trouble. Ah, forgive me. Where are my manners? Hey, fellas, come help me escort our guest. Our friend here is requesting a one-way trip to the afterlife. Shall we oblige? I get that your boss is a tough nut to crack, but you don't really need to make things so difficult. Give him hell, boys.
Yeah, I mean, this should be over pretty quickly. Oh no, it's another one of these dudes that just block constantly. I need to grab him and do the flip thing. Got him. Nice. Okay, one sec. Stop it! Oh my god, these dudes that just keep grabbing, they're so annoying. This game is full of them. What is that doing? What was that achieving? Whatever. So, a sex industry writer named Koichi Yabe was investigating a madam from Hong Kong and got him killed. What? Yabe's dead? So you knew him?
I did.
tell me where this boss of yours is.
She went back to Hong Kong this morning.
I see, so she had to skip town to keep a lid on Yabe's murder.
Maybe just say she learned too much about the organization for her own good.
You talking about the organization that Bridge runs?
Bridge?
What, you never heard of the name?
We're not important enough to know what's going on up top. All I know is the boss leaked something to Yabe.
And now Yabe's dead. I guess we'll never know what that was.
Don't be so sure about that. Yabe apparently hid whatever he compiled somewhere.
Really? Where?
Don't know. The organization's in a frenzy trying to find it.
Interesting.
Are you going to go look for it too?
You bet. I imagine it's some pretty valuable info.
You ought to stay out of it, or you'll end up just like Yabe.
Don't worry about me. After giving me all these details, you should be watching your own back. So Yabe hid some info, huh? But without any leads, I might as well be running in circles. There is that greedy old fortune teller. Guess I ought to rely on her again. No, but I don't think this is what I was looking for. The park? Hang on. I'm in the wrong block. But, I mean, it was good that I came here anyway. It's over here. There's something here. A person? Oh, no. It's not. Wait, does it mean here? Yeah, it's here.
Ah, we've been waiting for you. So you're the parasite of Kamurocho, huh? Real pleasure meeting the most crooked cop in town.
You the guys who attacked Homeland? Why did you do it?
Why? You've got some nerve to ask. Our mission is to punish people like you who prey on the weak. I've heard all sorts of things about you, how you extort piles of money from women who can't go to the cops, for instance. And now you know that... Now I know you and that chubby old man are in on it together.
What do you intend to do with the money?
What else but return it to the good, honest people you stole it from? That's why we brought you here, so we can get to telling us their name. Oh, and we're thinking we should break one or both of your arms, so good measure. Otherwise, you'd go right back at it.
I see. So, is that all you had to say?
What?
Just give me back the money already. You are done talking, right?
You little prick. You think this is some kind of game? Looks like we're going to be breaking more than just your arms.
Alright. Let's be quick about this. I like this move. This move's easy to pull off and it does a lot of damage.
Alright, give me the money. I'll never give it back. Not to a dirty scoundrel like you.
Ma-chan! Meha, what are you doing here?
I was so worried. I just had to come check on you. And it's not just me.
Huh?
You good, Tanimura? Makun, please tell me you're okay. We're here for you, big bro. Yeah, now step away from my- Yeah, you better not hurt him. Yeah. Who are all these people? I apologize. It looks like I made a terrible mistake. How could you believe some stupid rumors? And you better apologize to my dad, too. I'm sorry. Please forgive me, sir. That's enough, Meiha. It looks like it was just a misunderstanding. Maybe, but he just called you a chubby old man a few minutes ago. What? But you were in the wrong too, Ma-chan. You knew it was a misunderstanding right from the start. You should have talked them out of it instead of fighting. Yeah, I guess you're right. It's just that negotiating's such a hassle. Oh, Ma-chan. So, Yanagi, jeez. All that talk about helping the weak just now, was that for real? Of course, he's already helped out plenty of people in this town. This time was a bit of a clusterfuck, though. Alright then. Starting today, you're going to be helping the Asian Gateway. What? I imagine that you've been using those same violent methods that you used today in order to help people, correct? That may be one way of doing things, but too many things can go wrong. I just can't sit by and watch that happen. All in all, I do believe we have the same goal, so we should be working together, don't you think? Will you forgive us for what happened today? We're not in the Yakuza. As far as I'm concerned, what happened today is over and done with, so will you agree to help? I'd be honored to. Okay then, we'll teach you all about the Asian Gateway. From here on out, you'll be our official understudy. Sure, looking forward to it. Hey, I'm really sorry about today. Please take this as my apology to you. Come on, we got lots of work to do. Coming. Okay. Let's head back. I think we can finally rest. One sec. It just keeps distracting me with all these extra side quests. Like, what? I've tried to go back home to rest 3 times now and something pops up. Delay. Okay. There we go. What are you guys doing? Is something wrong? We've got some graffiti artists on our hands. That's been happening for a while now, hasn't it? Around Little Asia? No, this time it's different. What do you mean? It's written in Chinese, Korean, and even Thai. Is that such a surprise? Japanese is like a foreign language in this part of town. I can't argue with that, but I'm concerned about the people who wrote it. Do you know who they are? Yeah, it's probably some of our kids. How do you know? Because they wrote stuff like, I hate Japan for sending my dad away. And the Japanese don't think of us as people. Really sad things like that. You really think the Asian Gateway kids would do that? I mean, I really don't know, but since the kids in the Asian Gateway are left without parents, I'm not sure who else it could be. That's true. Alright, I'm gonna try and find who's doing it with a little talk with them. Fucking hell. For starters, where's all this graffiti? One's at the north entrance of Little Asia, another one in the building across from Homeland, and the last one should be at the entrance of... Okay. They usually paint their graffiti about this time when they're busy getting ready to open shop for the day. Okay, I'll start off with the north entrance to Little Asia. But if I do catch somebody, I wouldn't want the other kids to see. Good thinking. Don't take them to the Asian Gateway, then. Bring them to West Park. I'll be waiting there. Got it.
See you later, then. Yeah, it keeps tacking on the side quests. That's so... I think I'm going to leave it here for today. That's good enough. We shall continue next time. But I think a good amount of progress. I mean, I made some headway into this main story, so it counts. Alright, chat. I hope you enjoyed the stream today, but I am going to leave it here. And go online for the rest of the night. But appreciate you for watching and stopping by.